Hi, I'm Teri.
I'm Michelle.
And we are going to tell you guys the next step. Last video, we challenged you guys, just dream. Mm-hmm. Just dream and put it all out and don't have any restrictions. Don't limit yourself. A lot of the reasons that that is so beneficial is because mentally we just shut our brain off.
Right.
We automatically say, well, I would do that, but it requires this. And we just hate the process so bad that we just shut down. So mm-hmm. In the last video, we encourage you guys to dream it all out. So once you got all the realm of possibility laying out, how do you actually determine what you do next?
Right. So we talk a lot about when creating a dream board, if money wasn't an issue, if location wasn't an issue, or your age wasn't an issue, what would you put down? And that's where you just get an authentic idea of what is it that really empowers me or what I've always wanted. But once you have those things written down, now you need to go ahead and say, if I want to travel, money does become an issue. So we need to think about with our dream boards, what steps need to happen in order for that dream to become a reality. Mm-hmm. Teri and I, we have had the privilege of going to Italy, and that would have been at one point something on our dream board. But we knew in order for that to happen, there were steps that needed to come first. So when you begin taking your dream board apart, the very first thing that you want to do is, instead of becoming overwhelmed and now lose your peace because you feel like I have to conquer everything mm-hmm. in a day, is you just need to stop and realize this is a process. It does not have a timeline to it initially. You just want to look at your dream board and take a look at the very first thing that you feel I could start there. It doesn't overwhelm me. I feel like I have a lot of the variables in place, and there could be some movement a lot faster on with this dream than perhaps something else. The goal is to kind of have that snowball effect. They have, you know, we talk about that with finances. You pay off the smallest bill and then you just roll that over. That's the same premise with dreaming. Take the smallest thing that doesn't cause such change in your life and just begin some movement there. And then you could start redirecting your energy to the other things that are on your dream board.
Right. It's awesome. And I think, you know, some of us need to understand that it's okay to put things in phases. Mm-hmm. A lot of us have a temperament where we easily can see and create. But
right.
What we're realizing is that we see the mountaintops. We don't realize that that mountain looks really close, but there's about 5 years in between
right.
where I'm at and where it's at.
Right.
And that could be very discouraging at times.
It's a daunting task.
Yeah. You need to be okay with saying and prioritizing your dreams.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're going to challenge you about prioritizing your day and your work and yourself,
mm-hmm.
but you need to prioritize the things that are in your heart to do. If you're the mother of 5 little kids and you'd love to be somebody who does something that takes you outside of the house,
right.
you may be very frustrated to think that that's for this season right,
right.
now. So it's very important as well as you're going through to identify the season you're in,
mm-hmm.
the financial situation, and what are the practical approaches to knocking some of these things
mm-hmm.
out, what's for now and what's for later.
Right.
So let's do this thing. Go ahead and keep dreaming. Join us next week, and we're going to continue this series on how to get you guys where
yeah.
you want to be in 2020.